So I will introduce now Professor Kostas Georgiadis from the University of Peloponnese. For those who do not know, Peloponnese is in Greece. This is a region of ancient Olympia and modern Olympia also. And he's going to talk about Athens, which where he lives, and which hosted obviously the 2004 Olympics. You were a board member of the Athens Olympic Organizing Committee, weren't you?
Yes, yeah. I was.
So you know very well this topic. Thank you very much.
So, thank you, Dunes, and thanks for the invitation. My paper focuses on the Olympic legacy of the Games of Athens 2004, 10 years after they took place. More specifically, the purpose of our research will be to answer the following questions. Were the Olympic Games of Athens a good investment for the city and the country? Second, did the Olympic Games of Athens create a sustainable legacy in the city? And third, were the Olympic Games of Athens a good investment for sports events and sport in general? Fourth, what was the contribution of the Olympic Games of Athens to the Olympic movement? As a working definition, and there exist many definitions on the legacy, we used Sabeles. The legacy of the mega sporting events is all that remains and may be considered as consequences of the events in its environment. This definition, we believe, that refers to the imprint which the Olympic Games leave before and after their staging on a legacy that is planned or not, the positive and negative outcomes of the organization and the tangible and non-tangible structures left by the organization of the games. Regarding the methodology and the different types of the legacy, we relied also on Sabeles' model, which we think was the easier to work with that, with the five thematic units on legacy, tourism and economy, structure, sport facilities, urban and natural environment, and socio-cultural legacy. Moreover, we used elements for Holger Preuss, is the chairman, for soft legacy structures and hard legacy structures in our attempt to present more facets of the Olympic Games of Athens. The question that remain open for the Athens 2000 Olympic Games are, when did the Olympic legacy of Athens begin? From the 80s, when Athens was bidding for the Centennial Games in 1996 and some preparatory works had been made, or from 1996 when Athens announced its candidacy for the Games for 2004. Finally, how many years later can we consider the effects of the Games as their impact? Third, Athens also has a huge Olympic legacy left behind by the organization of the Olympic Games of 1896 and 1906. The Panhellenic Stadium that was being built in 1895 was completed for the Games of 1906. And as you can see, the photo was not completed in 1896 and used for archery events and the marathon race in 2004. It is still used today for various events, for example, for torch relay, Olympic day, and as a museum with a high visitors rate. Can we measure the legacy only for the Olympic Games of 2004, financially, culturally, and sportively, since it has been used during other Olympic Games? The numerous variables combined with the particular features and structures and Athens as city priorities compared to the other city, such as Sydney, Beijing, and London, to mention only those that were closer to Athens, make our work even more difficult if we want to have an objective depiction of the real legacy of Athens 2004. The study of the impact and the legacy left by the Olympic Games is recorded through the comparison of the social cost benefits that results from the organization. The way in which this relationship is assimilated by the society and which the project itself was, in which the project itself was released, constitutes the success or failure indicator of the games. For this reason, in a Panhellenic survey, we recorded the prevailing views of the Greek citizens regarding the Olympic Games of Athens in April 2015. That means almost 11 years after the Olympic Games. The research was carried out in cooperation with the Greek public opinion company, GBO, which organizes the political, social, and economic surveys. The purpose of the research was to record the views of people over the age of 18. This means that the younger people were 8 years old at the time of the Olympic Games. The sample of 600 people was countrywide, and the collection of facts was made through telephone interviews using a structured questionnaire. According to the results, which you see, a large part of the Greek public opinion, 47.7%, about 1 to 2, believes that 2004 Olympic Games in Athens had a positive impact in Greece. The percentage of those people is even higher among citizens of secondary and higher education, and also relatively higher among older people who lived the event. This fact is important because it still presents a positive attitude of the Greek population towards the Athens 2000 Olympic Games. Also, 3 in 4 Greeks recognize that they do not know the costs of the 2004 Olympics. It is also worth noting that the 25.6% who states that they know the cost, only 7.2% has the correct view about the actual cost of the games. Most of them characterize the cost of organizing of the Olympic Games too expensive, but from those who say that we know how much the Olympic Games cost, just only 7.2%, they know that the Olympic Games, they cost between 5 and 10 billion euros. As far as the individual sectors of the Olympics are concerned, the bulk of the Greek public opinion acknowledge the creation of major infrastructural works, 72.8%. The enhancement of national self-confidence, 69.6%. The development of volunteers movement, 68.84%. The improvement of hotel infrastructure, 66.2%. The telecommunication and technological infrastructures, 65%. The upgrading of public transportation, 65.1%. The upgrading of archaeological sites, 57.2%. And the increase in tourism, 61.3%. The upgrading of the touristic product, 53.8%, and the development of sport for all, 55%. And they increase, finally, awareness regarding disability issues, 66%, which is, I think, very high, all these numbers, and a positive attitude to the Olympic Games. On the other hand, most people believe that the Olympic Games did strengthen security in the country, 46.7%, and certainly increase employment, but not decisively, 38%. Moreover, only 34.2% believe that the 2004 Olympic Games did sufficiently upgrade health units and reduced air pollution in Athens. The Greeks believe that the Olympics did lead to a sufficient and satisfactory development of Greek sport, 41.7%, and sport infrastructures, 46.3%. The results of similar research connected with an ensemble of 60 people aged from 16 to 25 years were also particularly interesting. Most young people, 46, who had, they were in the age between 5 and 15 at the time that the Olympic Games were organized, believed that the Olympic Games have a positive impact, while 39.5 have a negative opinion. That is a research that we have done together with a school in Athens. Moreover, 80.3 believe that the Games boosted the national self-confidence and pride of the Greek people, and 68% that the organization of the Paralympic Games raised public awareness on disability issues. There are students who took part at that time in Olympic educational programs. And finally, the young people consider that the new Olympic education program is needed. About 80% they believe and ask of its inclusion in the curriculum. Because of the time, I will not go to the details, but even in this research, which we will have the attitude to the Olympic Games from the young generation was really positive. The question is, did the Olympic Games of Athens 2004 leave a legacy? So, the 37 new sport venues, the International Broadcasting Center, the Mass Media Press Center, the two logistic centers, the Olympic Village, the building of new roads, the underground and suburban transport, the port and airport, the seven media villages created the conditions for the city to become more functional and attractive. The stadium's renovation, based on the design of the Spanish architect Santiago Calatrava, created a new symbol for the city of Athens, like the symbol of Panathinaik Stadium. The weight of the metal structure is two arches is 2.5 times greater than the weight of the Eiffel Tower. For the Athens Games, the government created a special general secretariat for the post-Olympic use of sport venues, which, apart from one, all the others, they were permanent. After the end of the venue, the dilemma of consenting them for social use, renting or sale to the private sector remained strong and created so many discussions in Greece. Research conducted into 18 sport venues of Athens, Olympic Games, showed that at least 16 of them were used as sport centers or spaces for cultural events. This research did not include the Spiros Louis Olympic Center, since it was used to a large extent by football, basketball, tennis, swimming clubs, and the sport federations. That means we examined 18, and 16 of them, they were really used, but two not at all, and we will see some pictures for that. Moreover, the event provided the opportunity for many existing sport facilities to be renovated and used as training centers in Athens and in the provinces. The total cost of the new facilities reached 3.5 billion euros, and with the renovation of the old facilities, including the Olympic Stadium, a total of over 3.9 billion euros was reached. The speed with which the works were completed certainly had some side effects. For many projects, construction costs of the facilities increased. The softball and baseball venue should probably not have been permanent, since these two sports are not popular in Greece. But there are also other arguments there who say we needed to have a facility for softball or baseball. Sport policy in Greece needed to radically change at the legal and administrative level, both during the preparation and organization of the Olympic Games and over the post-Olympic period. The facilities were maintained principally by central government. The transfer of the facilities to the municipalities with the corresponding transfer of their operational costs led to reduced interest in their management and utilization. The impact of the games on the infrastructures and quality of life in Athens. In a city where there had been no investment since the 80s, the Olympic Games were seen as the opportunity for investing in infrastructures and the regeneration of Athens. Owing to the Olympic Games, over 40 projects were launched for the building of new roads, railway lines, and to be implemented in a short period of time. 25 kilometers of tramways, 150 kilometers of suburban rail, two new metro lines, and the traffic management center, and also replacement of the bus fleet with new low pollution vehicles. The Athens Metro, whose first 24 kilometers became operational 1 year before the Games, carried approximately 450,000 passengers. The number increased during the Games by approximately 505,000. The circulation of cars dropped progressively by 250,000 vehicles per day. Air pollution, noise, and petrol consumption were also reduced, according to some researchers. The tramway, 25 kilometers, which were delivered after the Olympic Games, carried 8,000 passengers daily. Moreover, the 30 kilometers of the suburban railway, which were delivered in the time for the Games, served 120,000 passengers. In connection to the airport and the metro, it is decisive important for the circulation in Athens. The suburban railway was built along the center of the fast Attica highway. It is a project of particular importance for Athens since it contributes to the reduction of traffic in the whole Attica area with direct access to the Peloponnese. So in 15 minutes you are through this road outside of Athens. In the past, we used 2 hours and sometimes more to go out from Athens. In the 80s, higher pollution levels were observed in different areas of Athens. That was a theme every day in the newspaper. After the candidacy of Athens, and since the mid-90s, we've seen a gradual reduction of the smog, and in particular, of annual CO levels in milligram per cubic meter. And you see the reduction of the pollution in the area of Athens. With the new airport of Athens, public transport can be considered as the most important legacy of Athens. Moreover, a series of other transport works, such as the new multi-level crossings on the Olympic rings, have reduced the traffic congestion, which had existed before the Games and succeeded in reducing air pollution. The upgrading of public transport led to an increase of passengers' movement from 2001, 697 million, until 2009, to 854 million by approximately 150 million transfers per year, which of course helped Athens. The impact of the Games on urban interventions and quality of life. The regeneration of the Phaleron waterfront is one of the most important urban regeneration projects in Greece. The Olympic legacy of the Phaleron Delta opens the city of Athens to the Mediterranean Sea. This was a huge intervention that combined efficient waste management, the revitalization of the destroyed biotopes in the area, stream control, and the expansion of vegetation by tree planting. That is the area, and on your left you see how the area was before in Athens in 2002. That was the situation. Before, in 2002, that was Phaleron also. I'm sorry. That is, I mean, in other these conditions, you could not increase the tourism in Athens. The second great treatment at the center of sewage treatment in Psyttalia was completed during the preparation of the Olympic Games, in connection with the upgrade of pumping stations along the coastal front and the flood controls on the river Kifisos. And huge also, very huge project which was ready before the Games. In a recent article, few weeks ago, is not my opinion, the newspaper Vima showed a photograph of two Caretta sea turtles mating in the Phaleron Delta. According to the specialists, this phenomenon was also observed in 2014 and in the spring of 2015, which shows that the upgrading of the Phaleron Bay waters has led to the return of rare species as well as making the water safe for the citizens to swim in the sea. And some of the pictures, that is the Kifisos River, that it is clean, still is unbelievable. As a result of the protection of the Schinias National Park, after the construction of the Rowing Center for 2004 Olympic Games, some important species have benefited. The marsh duck started to breed again in the wetlands and has multiplied very significantly according to the information which we had some weeks ago by Vima, from Vima Sciences called 24 of May 2015. During the Olympiad, through the Olympic education programs, that is Chinyas, what you see, that is during the Olympic Games, and that is the program during the Olympian, through the Olympic education programs, in cooperation with the Ministry of Education, 170,000 children in Attica took part in environmental educational programs, constituting a critical human force today for the protection of environment in their area. At the same time, testing of water quality commenced near the Olympic venues of Phaleron and Schinia. This legacy continues with controls at almost all pitches around Athens, with the water quality result published on the internet. And some of you who visit Greece, they know that you can go to all pitches around Athens. In 15 minutes, you are outside of the city, and we have clean areas there. The Games were an indicator for sustainable development from Phaleron area. A project of great importance is now being undertaken by Stavros Niarchos Foundation, it is in Rita, on the site of the former race track in Phaleron, which you see behind the picture, because it was moved, the hippodrome outside of Athens. There is built now. The Stavros Niarchos Foundation invested approximately 566 million euros for the design and construction of the opera and the national library, the new opera and the new national library of Greece, which will be handed over to the state in 2015. Thus, one of the most important cultural centers in the country has been created, and in accordance with the plans of the architect Renzo Piano, an Italian, the park with its sandal slope guides the visitor to the top of the hill, which is 32 meters high. This construction visually will link now the sea with the city and the Olympic facilities in Phaleron. A long planned facelift of Athens was completed with the unification of the archaeological sites via pathways and green space, the Acropolis, the Ancient Agora, the Panathenaic Stadium, the columns of the Olympian Zeus, and that the picture is before the Olympic Games, is the road around Athens, and that is today. It is a pedestrian which is used today by many Athenians and the tourists to walk around the Acropolis, is 45 minutes. The clean and renovation of many buildings, facades in the center of Athens, in combination with the dismantling of advertising boards, improved the appearance of the city. However, several projects were also not completed, is the buildings that were cleaned because of the Olympic Games, and some of them there is still in the center of Athens. Now, and a few words about the social legacy of the Games. After the Olympic Games, the Olympic Village was handed over to the Workers' Housing Organization. The organization made 2,292 houses available by lottery to the beneficiaries. Today, approximately 10,000 citizens are living there, 5,000 of whom are financial immigrants. This is another major social breakthrough of the Olympic Games of Athens. Even today, with the active involvement of residents, it could become a model housing complex on a beautiful site, which I visited recently there, but still I think those who live there, they have to take more care on that. I said to you that two facilities that are not used, there is the beach volley venue, and the other one, there is the facility on here, there is the canoe kayak facility, but they belong to an area which is called Ellinico, and this area is sold now to the private people. Another project of social importance was the renovation of Athens University Halls of Residence in order to accommodate journalists. According to the testimony of a student who had taken part in the students' mobilization against the closing of the Halls of Residence, and I quote him, after the end of the Olympic Games, we were particularly pleased to see that the Halls of Residence, which had been in very bad condition, were converted in a hotel, and new excellent facilities were created without charging the students. I personally had the impression that it was the first time that the Greek state had kept a promise towards its citizens, and it was a particularly pleasant surprise. I consider that it was the greatest social legacy of the Olympic Games of 2004. Let's see closer some of the financial impacts of the Games. The economic development that resulted from the investments in the Olympic Games was not strong enough to secure the country's economic stability, as we know today. Greece was not able to meet its objectives regarding the deficits and the public debt. The cost of the Olympic Games rose approximately to 8.5 billion euros. That is the budget of the organizing committee. It was 1,962,000,000, and of the state, 6,676,000,000. The largest part of the organizing committee income came from the TV rights and the sponsors, which boosted to a small extent the Greek economy. The investments that were made in Attica for the Games reached 3.5 billion euros, with a subsequent drop in unemployment to 6.9% from 2003 to 2009, the lowest percentage for unemployment that Attica had even known. At the same time, over the period of 2000 to 2008, before and after the Olympic Games, the GDP, the gross domestic product, showed a stable increase from 136 billion euros in 2000 to 245 billion euros in 2008. The debt of general government, however, rose from 138 euros to 362 billion euros. The rise of GDP did not reduce the country's debt or its external borrowing. On the contrary, the situation became worse because of the international economic crisis. The cost of the Games was small compared to the country's huge debt. And for that reason, I don't believe that a better planning from the day that the Olympic Games were started will save the economy. With other words, the Olympic Games, they are not responsible from the economical crisis which we have in Greece now. The effects of the successful organization of the Olympic Games were most visible in the tourist sector. Athens obtained a competitive edge through the promotion of the city's image. The increase in tourists was accompanied with a corresponding increase in income. Because of the Olympic Games, businessmen of the tourist sector invested 900 million euros until 2003, promoting an improved touristic product and combining it with a safe destination. Greece managed to reverse a period of stagnation and downward trends in tourist arrivals from 1985 to 1991. Despite the downward pre-Olympic course, already in the year of the Olympics, and even in the following years, there was a rapid increase in tourism. We observe an increase in the arrivals from 1996 to 2001, and immediately after the Games from 2004 to 2013. The arrivals from 2004 to 2013 increased by 6.2 million tourists for whole Greece. Last year, we have not the official information, but probably the tourist number was in 2014 approximately 23 million. That means 10 years after the Olympic Games we have more than 10 million more tourists in Greece. And this year, probably, this number will go higher. Just only in Barcelona, we have an increase of 300,000 tourists per year. Here, we have almost 1 million every year in the next years. In the port of Piraeus, important modifications were made just prior to the staging of the Olympic Games, primarily to cater the cruise line Queen Mary II during the Games. The result of this change was to dramatically increase the number of cruise tourists. For example, the number of cruise tourists increased in 2006 by 83% compared to 2005. That was not because of the Olympic Games, were also other reasons, but some huge increase. There were also bad side influences. Ancient Olympia is a typical example where, because of the Olympic Games, substantial aesthetic modifications were carried out in a small town which yearly welcomes approximately 500,000 of tourists. The town's central street was pedestrianized, car parks were created for the visitors, and the two museums of Olympia were renovated and equipped with new technologies, and the new hotels were built. In addition, the port of Katakolo is constantly being extended, with the result that the number of cruise tourists has increased at the archaeological site of Olympia, and in some times we have more than 12,000 tourists now in Olympia. A special legacy, which is related also with the International Olympic Academy, left the Olympic Games by the renovation and modernization of many facilities of the International Olympic Academy, which they were used during the Olympic Games as Olympic village. The replacement of the wooden doors and the change of the roofs in dormitories protected them from the huge fire which we had in ancient Olympia in 2007. Also, an outstanding archive on the Olympic Games of 2004 has been created, and you can visit that since last year as the legacy of the Games in the facilities of the International Olympic Academy. There are exhibits there, and the most important archives, which are digitalized and there are ready waiting for researchers. Another example, because of time, I will not go closer to that, which we examine, is the case of Argolis, the prefecture of Argolis, which is near Athens. It's only 100 to 150 kilometers from Athens, and is important because in this area there are very important archaeological sites, the archaeological site of Mycene, Epidavros, Nemea. Nemea is famous for the Panhellenic Games, Tirinth, and the beautiful city of Nafplion. There were also changes, and we can observe that immediately, because now it's easier from Athens to go there. It's just only 1.5 hours. In the past, they used 3 hours. The numbers of the tourists, they increased for the accommodation, the units, also the numbers, the tourist numbers, they increased in this area. Also, as legacy of the Olympic Games of Athens 2004, we consider the Olympic studies, the master's degree program, which we started immediately after the Olympic Games in 2009, with the title Olympic Studies, Olympic Education, Organization and Management of the Olympic Events. It's running now 6 years, and we had already students from 72 different countries from around the world. Conclusions. The main conclusion is that despite the extremely negative environment, the Olympic Games of Athens are deeply linked to the subconscious of the Greek people. The 2004 Olympic Games strengthened national confidence in their ability to organize large international events. I would say they also strengthened the geopolitical position of Greece in East South Europe, but we need more research on that point. As the country over the last 6 years has been facing a great economic crisis, causing major social problems, high unemployment, marginalization of certain groups of the population, massive negative psychology and pessimism, the fact that a large part of the Greek public opinion still has a positive attitude towards the Athens 2004 Olympic Games, I think is very important. And still we hear also just only negative comments about these games. There were major urban interventions that led to the cities opening toward the sea, making the Phaleron Bay a welcome space for the people. The ecological interventions in Schinia and Phaleron waterfront substantially improved the environment and contributed to the return of rare species in the region. The intervention in Athens, the unification of the archaeological sites, and etc., and the creation of tourist facilities combined with the training of thousands of young people made Athens more tourist-friendly. New urban transport facilities were created mainly in Athens and in Attica region, contributing to the daily of citizens' quality of life. New essential sports facilities were created in Athens and in other cities. We needed that. It's not, Greece was not developed. For that reason, we cannot compare that with London. The Olympic Stadium, in particular, is the symbol of New Athens and today hosts many sports federations, sport associations, and cultural events. Sport activities have increased, mass sport in particular. We have all around Greece marathon runs. However, we need more data on this question. The change in sport policies and management of the facilities is a subject that leaves more room for criticism. The impact of the Olympic Games on Greek youth is huge. They recognize their humanitarian and social dimension and their importance for youth education, world peace, and volunteering. Tourist infrastructures have been created along the country to welcome a large number of tourists. At the same time, services have been improved since the Olympic Games were a training school for the Greeks in this particular field. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kostas, for this unusual view from the Greek side, but I think it was very important to have such a view, and now we have maybe a few questions.
May I say something to your comment, unusual view?
For me, at least.
I started to work on this topic immediately after 2012 Olympic Games. I have been in the pre-Olympic Congress. And one of the professors who participated there, he said, I'm sorry, but I hope he's not in Greek here. I am convinced that the only country that has not an Olympic legacy is the only city is Athens. And because I asked him if he has been in Athens and if he lived in Athens, and he told me that the last time that he was in Athens was before the Olympic Games. He was reading that just the newspapers. So, for that reason, I think we are living there and we are feeling some of the changes in the quality of life.
That begs the question, why there is such a discrepancy between the perception outside of Greece and the perception you just gave us in Greece, or maybe in some scholars?
I think I cannot really answer this question. I think that we in Greece, if you know us, so we criticize everything in an easy way. Yeah, we speak a lot.
Yeah, it's the media.
It's the country of drama. Yeah? Yeah, of drama. Comedy and tragedy, both sides. As I asked one time my friend Lucien Fichter, his reporter, he says, the whole information comes from the Greek journalists. So if you go in Olympic facilities now in Athens, I said that to you that is the diving pool, which was created in 1991 for the Mediterranean Games and was not used during the Olympic Games, but still is there and it's empty, in very bad condition. Some of these photos are on the internet, just to show that the facilities of Olympic stadium and the whole area of Spiros Louis central area, they are not used. They are used, the cost, they went down. The total cost of running them, it cost the city, the whole facilities, all the area, about 7 million euros per year, which is not really huge. And the stadium is used by two clubs, football clubs. It used to be used by three football clubs. The basketball is used by Panathinaikos. The swimming, there are pools that are using by the Federation.
I think it's a great lesson for scholars. Please check your facts before writing or speaking about something you didn't visit or didn't check before.
I think we are not much better than the other cities, but we are not worse than the others. We are in the same level. There are some facilities, two or three, which are not used.
We'll see if it is a case in London, but maybe there are other questions. Many of you have been in Athens, probably, so you can check for yourself. Or in Olympia, it's a wonderful place. I hope you will go if you haven't been. Thank you very much, Kostas.
Thank you, though.